Hello everybody, I'm Maria Giulia Ballatore from Politecnico di Torino, Italy, and I'm going to present you the research SAperI, Approaching Gender Gap Using Spatial Ability Training Week in High School Context. This research has been done by me, Gavin Duffy from TU Dublin, Sheryl, Sorby from University of Cincinnati, and Anita Tabacco from Politecnico di Torino. By spatial ability, I mean spatial perception, mental rotation, and spatial visualization. There is evidence of a strong relationship between spatial ability and science and engineering career performance. That's a good thing, because spatial ability can be trained, and the train persists over time. But there is also robust gender difference. That is, typically males outperform females. If we look at the Italian situation, we see that bachelor students shows a huge gender gap in engineering, manufacturing, and construction. That's the same, that's mirroring what's happening also at the Politecnico di Torino, in which we have the 24% of female enrolled in engineering courses. The goal of Politecnico is to reach the 35% of females by 2024. For doing this, different projects are being put in place, but approaching the spatial ability is one of these. Then, our research question are girls interested in improving their spatial ability? Is intense training of 5 days sufficient to affect significant improvement? And if there was an improvement, was the improvement persistent over time? Then, in order to answer this question, we organize a project called SAperI project. SAperI stands for knowledge, and you can see spatial ability, per, that means for engineering. The project is divided in 3 steps. Step A involved 167 students, 74 of which were male, the other were female. In May 2019, they took a set of 4 spatial ability tests in order to evaluate their level. Then, 37 girls of them actually took the summer school in June. The summer school was organized with 5 mornings, in which we had 5 of the 10 modules organized by Sheryl Sorby in her course, and 3 afternoons, in which we have small competition in pairs or in a small group. Then at the end of the week, they retook the same set of tests. Again, in October, all 167 students came back to Politecnico di Torino and took again the same set of tests. The set of tests that we chose were the revised Purdue test for the mental rotation. If you want, you can stop the video and try to solve it. Then the second one is the Lapan test for the spatial visualization. Then the Santa Barbara for the mental cutting test. And then for the paper folding, the DAT. The results that we obtain show that also in our case, male were outperforming compared to girls, to females, in all the 4 tests. But the female interest in spatial ability were actually a representative sample of the girl that we test. That means that girl interest doesn't depend on their starting level. And the same for the one that actually took part at the school. If we look at the results of the girl that took part at the school, here you see in green their initial evaluation, in pink their midterm evaluation at the end of the summer school, and then in blue their final evaluation. You can see that only few of them did not improve or at least maintain their initial score. Moreover, the final evaluation was keep improving, or in some cases maintaining the improvement they had. Then, if we look at the survey, at the feedback survey we did, we receive a very positive feeling of the experience that also met their expectation, and they would suggest the school to other girls. Then, going back to our research question, we can say that girls are, independently from their starting level, interested in spatial ability, and the 5-day training was efficient and was perdurable over time. I'm looking forward to meet you at the TEEM conference and to have a fruitful discussion about our research.